Mike, we're in our same little lab that we've been scaling out or making it a little bit more complex with every step that we take. So what we're going to do now is we're going to configure DNS, but we're going to configure for name resolution. We configured DNS over here to a certain degree because we did SSH. And in order to do SSH, you need to turn on what's on already, IP domain hyphen lookup, but you need to have an IP domain name because you have a host name and a domain name that creates the key. Here, our basic purpose of in this particular lab is to turn on DNS and use it in together with this DNS server here. So we can do name resolution. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and go into this router. Now, I'm gonna come here and find out the IP address. 30.1, okay. So we got 30.1. So we're gonna go to the CLI. And this is, we'll talk about that in a little bit. Enable config T. And now this command, as I said previously, IP in our housekeeping lab, IP domain hyphen lookup, that's already on. It's on by default. Normally people turn this off because they're not using DNS for name resolution purposes. So they turn that off because if you fat finger the keyboard and the router's operating system thinks that you're looking for a name, you just sit there twiddling your thumbs unless you do Control Shift 6 to break out of that. All right, so IP domain lookup, IP domain hyphen name, and we'll just call it globed.net, okay? And then we'll point it to the IP name hyphen server, and that's going to be 192.168.30.1. So all right, so this is configuring DNS, right? We're configuring the DNS service to look for that server to resolve something for us, right? So instead of pinging, let's say we'll do a very simple example. Instead of pinging by IP address, you can ping by name. So we minimize this, we go to a server, and by no means or stretch of the imagination, all right, is this how you configure a DNS server in a real world environment. All right, so DNS, let's open this up here. So we go to DNS, turn it on. This is one of the things I always do, I forget to turn on. So the domain name is globed.net. And we're going to associate it, we're going to create that so we can actually see a web page, 192.168.30.1. All right, I want to associate it with this particular one, but so we can do www. But what we're going to do is R2, and we can associate several IP addresses, right? So we're going to associate, let's see here. All right, so we got 10.1.1.6, right, which is that interface right there. We click add, and then we'll change that to 10.1.1.9, which is that. Add that, and then I'll just select that again. And then we can actually use this right here, which will be 192.168.20, I believe. Yep, 192.168.20.254. So we have the same record, R2, which is an A record, and we've associated that with that those IP addresses, right? Now let's associate some more so we can ping other routers. I'm just gonna put one though, R3, all right, which is this router right here, and that's 10.1.1.10, and we'll add that, and then we'll do R1, and we'll do 10.1.1.5. Cool? Done deal. We haven't added that. Let's add that. All right, so we have R1, R2, we have several records, and R3, all right, that this should resolve. So I'm going to come here. I'm going to go to this router right now, and let's make a temple, and I'm going to ping R2. So you see that it's looking for a domain name, all right, domain name server 30.1. Either it's not finding it, or whatever the case may be, it's taking sweet time. Control Shift 6 to break out of that. Ping 192.168. If this is not working, one of the first things you want to do is say, do I have connectivity to it? And we do. All right. So what we can do is do a show start. We'll just go real quickly. Here we go. We have domain globed.net, and it's pointing to the correct server, all right? And then we go to the server and make sure that we have the right records. This is R2, okay? Ping R2, it's lowercase, not a big deal, all right? We don't have to do .NET or anything like that. All right, so we should be able to translate that address, okay? It's, okay, control C. All right, so let's ping R1, let's see what happens there. We can ping R1, and you see it's pointing to the domain name, okay? R1, it's pointing to a DNS server, I'm sorry, it's pointing to a DNS server, and then we can ping R3, pointing to a DNS server, ping R2, okay, just took a little bit of time, just not patient. It should work right away, all right? So this is what you can use DNS for. So it's not for telnetting and doing different things through name. Now, what I was going to say in the beginning before we started doing this, very simple. The syntax is not a big deal. And obviously, the packet tracer is so much easier to do a forward lookup zone with a host record, right, that you can do, a host A record. With the host names of all the different routers. But this would not be a real world solution that you would want to create, because this would be considered a wide area network, even if it's not, do you really want to go across a link to go down into a different network where there's a server or DNS server to then come back and say, okay, this is R2. I found who R2 is. Here's the IP address, go ahead and ping that. So no, that's just not realistic at all. All right, but again, it's just something fun that you can do, I guess. And one of the things that I put globed.net there is so when I look at this, you can test your DNS, www.globed.net, or you have to type in www, just type in globed.net, right? And it resolves it. So this is how you would check, right? You can just check it right here on the computer to see if DNS is even on and it's actually working. Because there's different places where you can really make a mistake. Where here, you don't have the DNS server in there. You have the wrong DNS server in there as well. In the services, you forgot to turn it on. And you don't have the sufficient host records. Now, one of the things that I can say is, like me, like I just did, you know, I got riled up because it didn't come, you know, didn't ping it right away. I was like, well, wait a minute, what's going on? I need this to ping it, once it's done, I need it to be able to ping. I don't want to have to wait. I mean, it's configured. You should be able to figure out what it is. Okay. But again, that's not something you want to do. All right. And I'll show you later on different ways of doing it by doing static host tables. If you really wanted to use names, you can do static host tables, which are not, it's not going to take any bandwidth across on your links because everything is, you have to do it in each particular router, but we'll take a look at that in a bit. So yeah, so this is DNS. All right, like I said earlier, the first router that we had here, we use DNS because we're doing SSH. Now I'm going to go here because I know there's a password on there, which I don't remember. Okay. Control Z, you did a show start. With all the basic housekeeping here, remember? We have the username and password. But you see that we did it here as well. But the purpose for us doing it here is for SSH. It's because we're doing SSH. I thought we were doing SSH, but that's why you would do it. Okay, it's because in order to create SSH, let's just do it real quick. IP SSH authentication retries, how many times you can allow somebody to get in, IP SSH timeout, it's gonna be 120 seconds, which is the maximum. I'm not gonna do a version, all right? But you can do a line, BTY 0/15. Oh, wait a minute, before we do that. So when you're doing that, one of the things you need is that, the host name, and then you need the domain name, which we already have. So we're gonna do crypto, because an SSH, the reason we do SSH is because it's encrypted, crypto key, generate RSA, and then but let's say we want to replace it. Let's say, okay, yeah, see how it says r1.globet.net. So you want to, I gotta type in yes, okay, and then we'll put in 2048 again. Oh, let's do something different. 10:24, a little less, whatever. So now, this is the reason, you can see it right here, that we need DNS. So we needed a host name, which you have to create, right? The host name of the router, and then globed.net, which is the domain name. It puts those two together to create these keys to be encrypted. So in here, in this particular router, we were using it for the purpose of SSH for the encryption keys, the RSA keys, right? The crypto key. And here, we're using it for name resolution. As you can see that here, we were using it to do globed.net, and we can see a web page, right? And that's just the default web page that the server brings. And if you know a little bit about HTML, you can change that around. But here, we used it for, again, just name resolution. Name resolution. But it's not something realistically that you want to do. It's not. Because it's going across a wider network, or it's going across a certain link to get into another network to find out a host record to come back and then for you to ping. Doesn't make sense. Doesn't make sense. All right. That was easy enough. I'll see you in the next one.